Hey guys, once again, welcome back to the new video. In this video, we are going to create an awesome looking text animation or title animation that is super easy to create in DaVinci Resolve. You can use this animation in any video editing project and make your videos so much better. I am Vikas from Skyline Motions, and without any further ado, let's open DaVinci Resolve, take a new project and get started. Alright, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve 18.6, and all you have to do the basic setting first. So click on the setting button in the corner and set the size of this project 1920 by 1080. Select a frame rate. So in this case, I'm using 60 frames per second for a smooth animation. And of course, you can select any frame rate that you like and click on save. Now we have to import a video clip for this animation. So it's very simple. Just go to media pool, right click on that, click on import media and select a video clip. So in this case, I'm using this video clip that I have downloaded from pixels.com, and I will give you a link in the description for that. You can find the free video clip from that website. And once you have downloaded the video clip, just select the video clip, click on open. And here we have two different options. So if you want to change the project setting according to the video clip, as an example, frame rate and size, then click on change. Otherwise, you have to click on the don't change. Now let's drag and drop the video clip on the timeline, just like that. And then I'm gonna make this animation by using an adjustment layer. So just go to effect. Here we have the adjustment clip. Let's drag and drop the adjustment clip on the timeline. And now let's match the duration of the video clip according to the adjustment clip. You can select any part of your video clip. And now let's jump into the fusion page. So go to very first frame of this animation, go to fusion page, and here we have the media in and out. So just deattach the media in and out. Here we have two different viewer. Just click on the single viewer and make it single. Now let's start by creating a background. So this is the background button. Let's drag and drop on the flow window. I'm going to use this background as a circle. So what we have to do, hit F2 on the keyboard to rename, or you can also right click on the background, click on rename, and let's call it circle. Hit OK. And now let's attach an ellipse mask with the circle. So this is the ellipse mask. Let's drag and drop on the flow window and connect the ellipse with the circle. Let's drag and drop the circle to the viewer. Now let's increase the size of the ellipse. So here we have the width and height. I'm going to set the width value 0.6, height value 0.6. Now it's looking perfect. And then you can uncheck the solid box. And here we have the border width. Let's increase the border width and set the value maybe 0.16. Perfect. Now let's animate the circle. So what we have to do, just go to frame number 120, which is equal to 2 seconds according to 60 frames per second. Here we have the width and height. So right click on width, click on animate, right click on height, click on animate. You can also click on the diamond button to add a keyframe. Just go to 180, which is equal to 3 seconds. Click on the diamond button and add one more keyframe and lock the position at 180. Just go to the end of this animation and then let's increase the size of the ellipse and set the value maybe 1.3 in width and 1.3 in height. And then just go to very first frame of this animation. Let's increase the width value 1.3, height value 1.3. Perfect. And now we have this type of animation. I'm going to add one more animation, which is the border width. So just go to 120 at 2 seconds. Right click on border width, click on animate and lock the value as it is. Just go to 180 again, lock the value. Go to the end of this animation. Let's set the border width value 0.1. Go to very first frame of this animation, set the border width 0.1. Now we have two different animation, the size animation as well as the border width animation. As you can see, it's looking much more interesting. And as you all know, the animation is linear right now, so let's make it smoother. It's very simple. Just follow this step. Just go to spline window, hit F4 on the keyboard to full screen, make it bigger. Before we proceed further, let's take a look at the amazing pack I Want It All bundle from AEGEUS. It is one of the best template pack for After Effects and DaVinci Resolve on the internet. This pack includes premium as well as free tools and plugin for After Effects that hopefully increase your production and save you so much time and efforts. Some elements of this pack including seamless transitions, shape elements, whiteboard animation, text preset and much more for absolutely free. All the links will be in the description box below. Please check this out. And here we have three different parameters. So I have to do one by one. So just check this border width first, click on fit button. So these two keyframes is for animation in and these two keyframes for animation out. We have to make this graph smoother. So what we have to do, just highlight these two keyframes, click on this smooth button, or you can also hit S on the keyboard to smooth. Simply highlight this point, it means this keyframe, and hold this handle and place the handle at very beginning of this animation where we have the first keyframe, and repeat the same process for animation out but in opposite direction. So highlight these two keyframes, click on a smooth button, hold this handle and place it just like that. And then we have to repeat the same process for all the parameters. So I'm gonna do this in fast forward. Perfect. And then you can close the spline window. And now we have smooth animation, as you can see. After that, I'm gonna use this black section as a mat and I'm gonna place this video clip inside of that circle. So it's very simple. We have to do this step. Simply, you can take a new merge node. Inside of the merge node, we have four different points. So the yellow point is for background, green is for foreground, this one is the effect mask, and this is the output. So what we have to do, I'm gonna use this circle as a mat. So we have to connect the circle in this yellow point, which is for background. So connect the yellow background point with the circle, and I'm gonna use this video clip as a foreground. So connect the green foreground point with this media in, and this is the merge one. Let's drag and drop to the viewer. Select the merge, go to inspector window, and here we have the operator, and as you can see we have this option over. It means the foreground is over on the background. So let me show you. This is the foreground and this is the background. Our foreground is over on the background, that's why we can't see the black section. So what we have to do, just select the merge one, go to operator and change this operator over to in. It means the foreground, which is the video, is inside of the black section, which is the background. So it's very simple, as you can see. Now you can click on the single viewer again, and here we have this type of effect which is looking absolutely perfect. Now we have to make a duplicate of this ellipse and circle. So select both the nodes, hit Ctrl C on the keyboard, hit Ctrl V to paste. Let's rename this circle to struct. All right, and this is the second ellipse, so you can rename it properly. Perfect. Now we have to do one thing with this second ellipse. Just highlight the second ellipse, go to border width and remove this border width animation. Let's set the value 0.005 or 6. And it's looking like this. I'm gonna use a white color for the stroke. So select the background, which is the stroke, and let's select the white color. And now we have to merge this stroke with this merge one. Just connect the output of the stroke with this merge one and we will get the new merge. Let's drag and drop to the viewer. Select the merge two, go to apply mode. And this time we have to select this blending mode overlay. And we will get this type of output, as you can see, which is looking very nice. And after that, let's create the background. So it's very simple again. Just take a new background node and drag and drop to the viewer. Let's create a gradient background, or you can also keep it black. So just go to type and change this to gradient. Here we have the gradient type. Let's set it to radial. And now we have the black section and this is the white. So select the white color, maybe dark blue. You can set the blue channel value maybe 0.12 or something, and we will get this type of a gradient background. Now let's merge this background with this main output. So let's take a new merge node, connect the yellow background point with this background green foreground point with this merge 2 output, and drag and drop the merge 3 to the viewer. So here we have something like this. Now let's create the main thing, which is our title animation. So what we have to do, let's attach a text tool on the flow window, drag and drop the text to the viewer, type your first line here, select your favorite font style. So in this case I'm using lemon milk font style. Of course you can select any font style that you like. Select the thin version of the font, and after that we have to turn on the guide for the reference. So just right click on the preview window, go to guide and turn on the show guide. Let's increase the size of the text, maybe 0.1, and you can set the text just like that. Perfect. And after that we have to type the another line in the bottom. So it's very simple, select the text one, hit Control C to copy, double click on the flow window, hit Control V to paste. You can rename it properly. So this is the text 2. Now let's merge both the text. So what we have to do, connect the output of this second text with the first one, we will get the new merge. Let's drag and drop the merge to the viewer. After that select the second text and type your second line here. Let's increase the size of the text. I'm gonna set the value 0.13 or something. Select a bold version of the font and drag it right over here. Perfect. Now we have to animate the text. So it's very simple, just follow this step. Let's take a new rectangle mask, place the rectangle over here, attach the rectangle with the text one, increase the width of the rectangle. For the first text, let's place the rectangle just like that. And now for the bottom one, what we have to do, let's take another rectangle, connect the second rectangle with the second text, and let's increase the width value. And this time we have to place the rectangle in the bottom direction. You can keep the upper edge at the center just like that. So as you can see, this is the first rectangle and this is the second rectangle. Now let's animate the text. So select the text one first, go to frame number 90, which is equal to 1.5 second, go to layout, right click on center, click on animate, and just select the second text and do the same thing. Just go to layout, right click on center, click on animate, just go to frame number 210, which is equal to 3.5 second. We have to lock the position as it is by adding a keyframe. Select the first text, add a keyframe. Just go to the end of this animation, drag it in the bottom direction and hide the text just like that. Select the second text and drag it up and hide the text. All right, we will get this type of animation. Now just go to very first frame of this animation, drag the bottom text in upper direction and hide the text, and drag the upper text in bottom direction, and we will get this type of animation. Now let's make it smoother. It's very simple again. Just go to spline window, hit F4 on the keyboard to full screen, make it bigger. Just uncheck all the nodes, check the text 1 and 2 only, click on fit button. You can do this task one by one. So select the text 1 first and repeat the same process. Close the spline window, and now we have a smooth animation as you can see. Now let's add one more animation, which is again very simple. Let's take a new transform node. This transform is going to be the animation, so I'm going to call it animation. Connect this merge 4 output with the transform, drag and drop the transform to the viewer, and then we have to create a scale animation for this. So just go to frame number 120, right click on size, click on animate, go to frame number 180, which is equal to 3 seconds, right click on size, click on set key. You can also click on the diamond button, as you all know, and then just go to the end of this animation. Let's increase the size of the text, maybe 1.3. go to very first frame of this animation, set the size 1.3. perfect. And here we have zoom out animation, as you can see. Now let's make it smoother. Let's go to spline window, hit F4 on the keyboard, and repeat the same process for animation, just like that. And then you can close the spline window, and after that let's merge the text with the main output. Connect the output of this animation with this main merge, and we will get the new merge. Drag and drop to the viewer. Now let's connect the merge 5 to the media out, and then just go to the edit page, and here we have an awesome text animation, as you can see. Now let me show you how you can create multiple slides. So it's very simple. All you have to import a new video. So just go to media pool, right click on that, click on import media, select any video clip that you like, drag and drop on the timeline. Now select the adjustment clip, hit Ctrl C to copy, hit Ctrl V to paste. You can select 5 seconds of your video clip, and then place the CTI on the second adjustment clip. Go to Fusion page, and here we have to change the text. So select the text one first and type your first line. Select the second text and type your second line, just like that. And then you can go to the edit page, and here we have our second title animation. So just go to very first frame of this animation, turn on the loop button, hit Ctrl F to full screen, and let's have a look. Alright, so it's looking absolutely perfect, and that's all for this tutorial. I hope you guys like it. If you like it, then hit the subscribe button, turn on the bell notification for more interesting videos, and also hit the like button for this video. My name is Vikas, and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.